Chris Aaron and I have a great show in store for you. Going to share with you a vision about a city of refuge, that and much more. Don't miss it. I'm Larry Rice, and this is Here's Help. God is doing so many great and mighty things. But right now, it's so bitter cold out there, and our teams are trying to help people stay alive. That's why we're giving out the propane heaters and the propane, and need to get out the bus tickets. So if they just can't find any other place to go, they can get on a bus and stay warm. Chris Aaron, it's tough out on those streets.
Yeah, it really is. I think many people underestimate just how hard it is really to survive. Particularly with sleep deprivation and being turned away over and over and over again. The reality is that we treat our pets a whole lot better than we do human beings who are created in the image of God and who deserve dignity and respect.
Growing numbers of human beings are living in tents right now because they've given up, particularly in the St. Louis area, on the shelter system, and also in Springfield. They're moving out into tents, and they're cold out there, and our teams are going out. I want to go to my son Chris, who's interacting with the folks and getting them propane heaters and propane. And then Joe's out there throughout St. Louis County. And Ray, our teams are out there on your behalf, but we need you to share those much-needed tax-deductible gifts with New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, that's 63166. It's a matter of life and death. We have to get these heaters out. We've got to get the propane to the people. We must get these bus tickets. So that they not only can go to their for appointments, but get on the bus and stay warm. So many people are hurting. Let's go to Chris.
Tell us your name.
My name is Debbie Yarber.
Okay. And Debbie, you're living in a tent out here in Springfield, and we just got you a portable propane heater and gas tank and propane regulator hose. Tell us how this is going to benefit you.
Tremendously. I'm on so much blood thinner, and it's so hard for me to stay warm anyway. But tremendously. If you've never been cold, early this morning when I woke up, my feet were so cold. I mean, trying to bundle myself up into blankets and whatever else, and it's not easy. And hypothermia and all that kind of stuff, and that's the last thing I need. But I will light this thing, warm myself. I can take my sponge baths and whatever else. Tremendous, and it will also help to keep my dog warm.
Okay.
Because she's of age. She's, 16 years of age.
Mm.
So
all right. We want to let you know that this is all because Jesus loves you, and we love you, and we want you to know that you're cared for. That's why we got this for you.
Thank you, and I appreciate it. When Pastor Mark came up to me yesterday about this, I mean, I knew who put the little birdie in his ear, and that would be Chrissy and Robert, and very good friends of mine. They've helped me tremendously as well. But when I heard about this, I just wanted to sit there and cry. I mean, this deal here, I mean, I had the money, but I have responsibility as well as my dogs, my son's dog, my son, and myself, to keep us fed and whatever. Because it's not easy for me to get around, to get food and stuff. And my son he's going over, he's bending over backwards left and right to try to care for me. That's really not his responsibility, but he does it,
Mm-hmm. Well, God bless you, Debbie, and you have a great day.
Bless God. Thank you.
All right, so we are county outreach, and we come out once a week and we visit with Dan.
Yeah.
And Dan was telling me tonight that he needs a heater, and we were just blessed with this heater today.
Nice.
Through our donors. And we were able to give him a gas bottle to go with it.
Yeah.
And so Dan, how is this going to help you out?
Bro? Oh, this is going to help in Members' Relief. I get it. with the gloves and what they gave me and the long johns, I'll be able to stay warm.
Good. And you're staying where, Dan?
I'm living down here at the Metrolink in a tent.
Okay. Yeah. So, all right. And so this will help you stay warm?
It will help me stay warm and get through these last couple months of winter.
All right.
And I've got, I'm waiting on my disability to come through, so.
Are you ready?
Yeah, yeah.
That's sweet.
And
I hope you get that.
Yeah, me too.
Real soon.
Me too. It doesn't take 3 years or something.
Yeah.
You know, so.
Yeah, so how long you been out here, Dan?
It'll be 4 years in March.
Wow.
4 years. I was thinking about it. Where did that time go? It just flew by,
Cause, well, I think, remember, we met on Natural Grid.
Yeah, yep, that very
about
first time.
4 years ago,
I remember yesterday, right there when I was, I was up there, like, my last money in the motels up there now, yeah. And then right after that is when I...
And praise the Lord.
Yeah, thank you.
Somebody donated this to you, and we were able to supply that to you,
Dan.
We appreciate you, Dan.
And I thank you guys for coming down.
And we always have the farm open to you.
I know. And you know what? It's getting...
I believe you do well down there.
Yeah.
I do.
Yeah.
Well, all right. I appreciate it, brother.
Yep, thank you, guys.
Take care.
Thank you very much.
All right.
Thanks, Glenn. And you guys out there, thank you all for your donations. So.
Yeah. Hello, I'm Chris Rice, and I'm here with Robert and Christian. And we're at their campsite, and today we're bringing them a propane heater propane, and we're just visiting them in their campsite, and I want to see that they do well. So how is this going to help you, the heater?
It's going to be a big blessing for us. There's a lot of times where the shelters ain't open, but the night temperatures get cold enough that you need some kind of heat source. Mm-hmm. And there's a lot of times that during the day when it's cold out and we got to be down there and it's cold out. So with this winter coming on, it's just getting later in winter, and there's going to be a lot of people out here that won't go get help. So for you guys to come out here and help us, it's a big blessing. We really appreciate it.
All right. So what does it mean to you to have this propane heater?
It'll keep me warm because I'm like anemic, so I get cold easily at night. So it will help me a lot more to keep me warm at night.
And you got your little dog Mischief here.
Yeah, and it'll keep her warm too because she has thick fur, so.
Yeah.
We don't have a winter coat for her yet.
Well, we just want you to know it's because Jesus loves you that we're giving you all these gifts. And we just want to encourage you at home to give to the work of New Life Evangelistic Center. We'd like to give out more of these propane heaters and tanks, but we need you to give. The propane heater itself is about $75, and the tank was $58, and the hose was $15. So if you just, donate that amount, we would sure appreciate it. Thank you very much.
People are hurting out there, but God has placed a vision upon myself and Chris Aaron for a city of refuge. This is so exciting. We're going to be going into detail on that on February 17th at a very special dinner. We're going to be sharing that with people. What do you find most exciting about the city of refuge vision, Chris Aaron?
I think the most exciting thing is that it takes a lot of different components of who we have been at New Life Evangelistic Center and where we are seeking to go in the future. And it melds them all together into a beautiful vision that could really only come from God. When I say that this vision is big, I mean it. It encompasses a whole lot more than just New Life. New Life is moving ahead by faith and seeking to inspire businesses and churches and political leaders and communities to think about a Christ-centered approach to the address of the crisis that we have with people who are experiencing homelessness. And so, in many ways, we try to approach, we think outside of the box. We think in terms of mentorship or discipleship. We think in terms of a residential, campus of life-giving resources for men and women and children. And so it is really exciting, and it takes all of the best elements of what's being done in a variety of different ways but putting them all together.
52 years putting together. It involves a 16-acre campus. 8 of those acres New Life and the partners would work on. And what does that mean? All these people you see struggling, living outside that can't get in anywhere else, we're going to bring them in and set aside some of that acreage for them to put their tents up, have restroom facilities and the like, and also building a shelter in the wintertime. They'd be able to come in and have a warm place to go. And then on top of that, put in tiny dome homes and train people in skills. And then extra 8 acres, we're going to bring in industries and businesses and jobs. It can happen. We're building off of 52 years of experience of homeless people being trained, operating television stations, renewable energy products, projects, shelters, so many different things we've seen over the last 52 years. We want to bring that into being. We want to share. Now we're going after mayors in local communities outside the city of St. Louis. You listen to these city of St. Louis politicians, they're good at talking in circles, but they, 15 years, this planned petition, not a single shelter is open, Chris. And they shut down 14-level locusts. So we're looking at mayors, low-income areas, and we've already got one interest, and I believe there are going to be others, that we're bringing on board, and they're helping us locate these sites.
Yeah, and I think what's important to remember is just that often with big visions like this, it takes time and faith, and it takes people who are going to use the gifts that God has given them in unique and bold ways. And we haven't seen a vision like this really come forth in a long time. And so it's something we're praying quite a lot about. But we need people to even just inquire about this and start getting involved today. We need people to seriously consider, how can I make a lifelong impact, leave a legacy of change in the lives of thousands of people by investing in something that's much, much bigger than myself?
And that's why we're going to the mayors, low-income areas, sharing this vision with them. They're helping us find ground. And I want to include you, because we need people from the business community involved, ministers involved. There's so much, and we've got a complete plan that we're putting together that you can contact us, and we'll lay it all out for you on February the 17th at Orlando's Restaurant. You'd like to come, call us 314-421-3020. Get involved in this or write us. But I want to share with you an interview that Zaki Baruti did with an older woman, Hubbard. And you'll see, as he asked her questions about the homeless and the like, can you tell us where they can get off the streets? Can you tell us what we do now? It's good we all meet together. And then he asked her also about New Life. And, well, you're going to see that, well, the time has come for us to move from St. Louis City into a municipality. We'll be embraced by the community, and we've got some that are doing that. I'll tell you more about that, but let's go to Zaki.
I'm here with auto lady Shamine Clark Hubbard. And Hubbard, the issue of housing, you know, it's going into 2024. It's a real heavy issue for the city of St. Louis, but not just the city of St. Louis, really across America.
Absolutely.
What are your thoughts as an older person and just as a person, as an activist? How do you see that issue?
My thoughts on that I would go back way before I was an older person, as a human being.
Right.
As a mother of five, you know, as a person who lives in this community, it breaks my heart to see how the unhoused are being treated here in the city of St. Louis, the manipulation that's being done to them, and the way that they are being used sometimes as a tool for other people's agendas that are not in the best interest of them and the life and the challenges that they are having and dealing with on a day-to-day basis right now. I can sit in my office at the Board of Aldermen and see the unhoused encampment that's in place right now, today, at the old city courts building.
Mm-hmm.
And the activities I see there, again, are heartbreaking. And so there is in no way that I, in my position, would condone or encourage or do anything intentionally to enable that behavior. What I would support is intentional encampments, and I have supported in the past, not just by vote, but also by funding.
Support what now? I'm sorry.
Intentional encampments, not just by voting, not just with my vote, but also with funding pieces, and I can pull back the board bills and show you what those are. We had a very good example of that St. Patrick's Center had, which was Camp Cole. We can try to create spaces like that. We can look across the country and see what people in cities are doing for their unhoused to create housing spaces, intentional encampments, or housing first, which is where, again, my heart is, continuum of care, wraparound services, not just giving them the spaces, but making sure you put them on a trajectory to change their lives moving forward generationally for the children that might be either with them now or that they might bring into the situations in the future. This is the kind of work and the side that I want to be on.
Well, you know, in general, as far as I look at it, you know, with this country's the wealth that the opulence of mm-hmm. the wealth, it's a doggone shame that we got the kind of homeless crisis that we have. Would you not agree? I mean, just I'm talking about with all the riches that this country has, it's a doggone shame. Look like it's a crime against humanity in my mind. Mm-hmm. Your thoughts on that?
I agree, but you can't really box it into that because you don't know each individual that's out there part of our, and one of our unhoused neighbors has a different story, on why they are in the situation or why they are either choosing or not by fault in the situation of being unhoused. So for me, I can't just box it in to say, oh my God, all of the unhoused is just this type of person or that type of person, or they made this type of choice or that type of choice. I think the best thing that in continuum of care and what our Department of Health, Human Services, I'm sorry, under Dr. Adam Pearson and prior to that under Dr. Eustace Scoggin, who has done an amazing job in that space, and the other people that work in the Department of Human Services and the Department of Health for the City of St. Louis work to build those relationships. What I've learned from people like Dr. Punch and the T and Power for STL is that when you build the relationships, you can change people's minds. You can change them to want to even want more for themselves to move out of these spaces. You have people that take advantage of them and manipulate them daily. And I see it. This ain't nothing I heard about. I see it daily because of their shortfalls, because of their downfalls. And it has nothing to do with them wanting to be in housing or not. It's what those people and those entities' agendas are. I can't speak for that. I also don't have to answer for it. That's the piece I have in that. Let them do what they're going to do. But for the role and the position that I can play as an older person in the City of St. Louis, I'm always going to be on the side of creating spaces that are for the better and for the greater good of the City of St. Louis. And for me, it's always going to be housing first.
You know, New Life Evangelistic Center at one time had a facility in the City of St. Louis. Your thoughts on the work that Reverend Rice has been doing?
I'm gonna be honest, that was prior to my tenure at the Board of Aldermen. I was not down there, not in the area, in the community, or at the Board of Aldermen, so not privy to any of the work that was being done, and I just don't speak on stuff that I don't know.
Okay then. Well, on that note, I appreciate your comments on the issue.
Yeah, anytime. Told you when I need to speak, I speak now.
I know that's right. All right, thank you, and God bless.
Thank you.
We can keep talking about this, St. Louis City politicians, or we can do something about it. And that's what we want to do here at New Life Evangelistic Center, a dynamic vision, the city of refuge. We're taking people just like they are, where they live in the tents, where they're at, bringing them in, see that they have help they need. Too many people are suffering right now, and people are, it's cold out there. They're miserable out there trying to live out there. We're trying to just get them the basics. And what we're doing right now is going to the unsheltered, helping them survive out there. Whether it's propane heaters or even a little tent, sleeping bags. I mean, there's so many we're working with right now. Chris Aaron, whether it's a Springfield, and we have a whole, all day long they come in there. Then they go out at night. We got to try to help them. We might have a city of refuge there, but particularly in St. Louis County, we're looking at that over in Illinois. I mean, we've got to help these people, and they're hurting now. And that's why we need people from the community to catch the vision and run with it if they could only see what we see on a daily basis.
Yeah, I think that's true, that the kind of out of sight, out of mind nature of this problem makes many people think that it's not really that big of an issue. But the reality is that every single year, every single winter, we have people who do pass away just from exposure. And, you know, a lot of people say, well, it's because they do this or they do that or they're this way, you know. If that's what Jesus' approach was to us, that because of our sin, you know, he couldn't come and help us, none of us would be saved. And so I was just reading in Luke or Matthew today where he says, I didn't come to save the righteous. I didn't come to call the righteous. I came to call the sinners. And Jesus, like the great physician, takes the burden of sin himself. And so when we look at serving other people, we need to set aside our preconceived notions of why they're there. And we need to associate with them. We need to get to know them and to love them well, just as Jesus loves us well. And he doesn't leave us in our sin, right? He never does. He empowers us to break the bonds of sin. And we're trying to empower people to break the bonds of homelessness. But some of the things that people see or they assume is wrong with them, drug addiction, mental health, all these things, they're critical. They're keeping them there to some extent, but we really just have to show them the love of Jesus Christ. You've heard from Angel herself about just the real nature of people who are experiencing homelessness this winter. We need your help. We need you to partner with New Life Evangelistic Center by helping us provide heaters and propane tanks and blankets and sleeping bags and tents and so much more, because New Life for 52 years have been putting the things into the hands of people who need the most. We need $25,000 by the end of this month. Please pray about how you can get involved today. Go to NLECSTL.org. Again, NLECSTL.org. Or call 314-421-3020 and get involved today. You make a real big difference in the lives of so many people.
People are suffering out there, folks. Be part of our warm-a-thon. That's what it is. He mentioned $25,000. Not only will that help us get the propane heaters and the propane, but also we're spending thousands of dollars a month on metro tickets because a homeless person is desperate out there. They don't know what shelter they can get into because they call 211 and they're constantly put on hold and they're constantly told there's no place for them to go. And they're left in the cold. They'll get on a bus and they'll ride. And that's why we're spending thousands of dollars by state tickets. In addition to that, all the other things we're trying to do, if it gets real, real bitter cold, we've got to put them in motels. We need your help. And that's why I'm asking you to share that gift now. It's a matter of life and death to a lot of people. We're not just giving you a lot of great talk about all the dynamics of homelessness or whatever they do, the politicians. We want to directly help them. It's New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. You can give online at nlecstl.org. We need a financial miracle right now, Chris Aaron. The donations are down way below where they should be. We need just the people of God to go to God in prayer right now. He answers prayer. He's given us all these promises. How can we sit back and do nothing when there's so many people we see suffering out there?
Well, we can't sit back and do nothing. We have to act. We have to be the church. We have to express the love of Jesus Christ with our hands and our feet. And we do that in tangible ways. And so the church needs to get involved today. And we need you to give right now. Your gift goes so much further than just impacting one person. It impacts so many, really, here at New Life Evangelistic Center. And we thank our partners who have worked with us.
And that's why we got a warm-a-thon going on through this month. You can call, make a pledge, 314-421-3020. That's 314-421-3020. You can give online at nlecstl.org or just write out that check now and help us to save lives. I even invite you to come out with us and meet these individuals. See them face-to-face. Go out with Brother Joe throughout St. Louis County and Jefferson County, or Pastor Ray throughout the city in St. Louis. Link up with Mark and Chris in Springfield. There's so many people hurting right now. Just in Springfield, we have between 150 and 200 people every day that they're working with, that most of which are living out on the streets. Another 75 to 100 just in the greater St. Louis area that are out there that we're contacting, not even getting to shelters. Or call, as I mentioned, call 211. They get the runaround. So they just resigned themselves to the fact they have lived in these tents. We have to get this propane to them and the tanks and the like. And then we have all these people that are in safe houses, training centers and the like. So we need you to be praying for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center. Share your gift for this warm-a-thon. 314-421-3020. You can give online at nlecstl.org and make a big difference while the politicians are discussing the problem. New Life's out on the front lines doing something about it, Chris Aaron.
That's right. And that we've been doing that for 52 years. We're a trustworthy ministry that, we're not profiting really off of what people give. We get all of those resources and we try to be good conduits, stewards of what God gives us to bless so many people. And on average, every single day, New Life Evangelistic Center is either feeding or providing much needed resources to anywhere between 700 and 800 people a day all throughout
Mid-America. Yes, and we need your prayers at this time. There's many, many needs, brothers and sisters. I wished I could take each one of you out there, take you to where Angel and her husband James live and all the people that live around them. Take you out to these tent communities. Take you out where you can see it and experience it yourself, and then let the light and love of Christ shine through you. 314-421-3020. You can give online at nlecstl.org and let the power of Christ work in your life right now. We need people to get involved. They can call 314-421-3020. They can go online. We need people now. We're just about out of time. They need to get involved, don't they?
Yeah, and become a monthly partner with us, because this is such a great way for you to know that you are making a big difference. When you join our Club 24, you join our $50 a month giving club, it makes such a big impact in the lives of so many.
And New Life Evangelistic Center, as he mentioned, has been out there 52 years. It has a major apprenticeship program, unlike many other agencies. Most of the people doing the job were once homeless themselves that we've been able to teach, and they've come to know the Christ in a mighty way. We provide residence for those that are in this apprenticeship program. We're trying to be there when people are hurting, and we're going out with people that have been totally left out alone. More and more unsheltered people. People are going to die if we don't do something now. Please share that gift with New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. You can give online at nlecstl.org. Help save lives and help us to share. There's hope. Christ is risen. Help us to share that message of salvation.